Alright, I'm back. Sorry about that. Here we go. Okay. Gerald's mercenary has appeared. Oh, they just show up right from the start, huh?
Did we make it in time? The situation doesn't look great, but we've still got a job to do.
We'll cut a path for you. Follow us.
You're burning that thing. We secured the escape route. Get your troops out of here. The mercenaries. You have my back. Everyone, proceed to the escape route at once.
Your luck's run out.
I don't care. No. I really don't want to do this, but I can't let them get away.
Don't let Fernand retreat. Where's Fernand? Okay, so I haven't opened up the road yet. Hold on. How is she still doing sniping when you find her? Oh, Bernard is here. Okay.
Did you see that? We'll do it together.
so sad! Bernetta, no! It's so sad! Oh, I might be facing the wrong way. To hit, I think I missed all of these, which that hit. Yeah, I definitely missed all of these. On the bed? Face and defeat Doubt. Will I one-shot Doubt? What's this? Is he dead? No, not yet. Alright, that's fine. Alright, two-shot. Drove back Doubt. Sure. Hold on. Yeah, you deal with this dude. All right. Hold on, is the Pegasus Knight running somehow? Don't let Ferdinand retreat. Where's Ferdinand? Okay, so that's the retreating point. Okay, that sucks because I was going to use the art. Fail to defeat dude, like the Pegasus Knight are not fighting you, they're just like trying to run to a location. I think after they reach the location, they just like, you just fail that size thing. So that's like, that's stupid. It's not easy to actually try. It's not easy to catch the Pegasus Knight. If you don't have one on your own, then you're pretty much not gonna finish that side mission. Stop! I keep taking damage from these guys. Okay, you know what? Forget Ferdinand dead? Oh, I can still fight, which means the mission's not over. Oh yeah, there's another one here. You wanna bet? Dude, stop! Let me switch. There we go. Need another 100 kills. Alright, almost there. Oh, there's two of you. I didn't realize there were two of you. All right, got it. How about this? All right, we're done. Ignaz, paint her a picture, so she can remember what the Edgar looks like. Done and done. Well, we killed Bird and Edda, so there's one less Black Eagle in this world. Also, Lindhart's dead.
Yet you're still the saddest looking fighter in camp. Why the long face?
Because we only barely got the job done. Everything else was a miserable failure.
We too shot at him, her. Two shot at her.
Basically, we lost in nearly every way you could lose.
Wrong. You were hired to do a job, and you did it. And in the process, you've received a valuable reminder about the unique danger the Ashen Demon poses.
You're right. I can't believe one fighter can turn the tide of an entire battle like that.
Precisely. They're surely going to continue standing in our way, so do try to dig a little deeper the next time you square off.
Yeah, you're probably right. Thanks for the check.
Nice. Golden apple. Sure.
There's always room for improvement.
Really? That's sure, whatever.
I still have a long
run. Everybody who needs it get a level up except Balthus. So yeah, I'm pretty happy about this. It's not bad. Bunch of steel and iron weapons. Energy drop too, huh? Charm by 2, strength by 5. Okay.
Did you manage to find Ferdinand and his troops?
No, but I spotted tracks that suggest they fled toward Eric Mock.
So they've given up on the southern route and are making their way back to the Empire by circling west. It won't be easy to catch them down.
I'm just relieved that Ferdinand is still alive. I must admit, I am too.
Yeah, same here. I just wish we could have caught him, though. Knowing Ferdinand, he's gonna think the only way to redeem himself is by attacking us again.
if he does. I'll just chase him away. I'll set that guy back in as many times as we need.
I'm more worried about Gerald and his mercenaries.
I'm with you on that.
Right. Ferdinand would have never escaped if Gerald's people weren't covering him. I suspect this won't be the last we see of them. We can't let their smaller numbers lull us into a false sense of security. That's a surefire way to get beaten. On the bright side, we've taken down most of what was left of the Imperial Army's invasion force. I think it's fair to say the Alliance has officially made it to the other side of this crisis. Great work, everyone.
May I ask what our next move is, my lord?
Well, as you know, the Empire is currently locked in battle with the Kingdom of Farkas. With fronts to the east and the west, the Empire stretched thin. They've been forced to divide their army. I'd be curious to hear what my favorite mercenary thinks. What would your next move be?
As the brains of this duo, I'll take this one. The answer couldn't be clearer. Attack the enemy's homeland.
Suggests fortifying the border, invading an empire.
The Great Bridge of Murden, mount an assault on Empire territory. If we move in now, we'll have a real shot at winning.
Exactly what I was thinking. We should seize the initiative and strike before the Emperor and Count Burgles can muster a response.
I agree. They attacked us first, so we're fully justified in retaliation. What's more, if we can claim House Burgles as farmlands for ourselves, then the Alliance should be sitting pretty for a century to come.
Isn't Count Berkeley's known for his incredible strength?
He may be a Dresti as mighty as a warrior, but at the end of the day, he's still just one man. The Empire's invasion of Leicester has failed. That crack in their armor is just the opening we need to strike.
If victory means peace for the Alliance, I'm all for it. I won't lose to this count.
I'm sure if we don't take this opportunity, it won't be long before the Empire regroups and attacks us again.
I don't approve of this at all. Surely the Alliance Army is already exhausted from fighting multiple battles.
So many of our soldiers are wounded. We should give them time to rest and recover.
If our attacks were to somehow fail, the Alliance would be plunged right back into crisis. And need I remind you, the next time the Empire knocks on our metaphorical door, we will not be able to employ the same tricks again.
We will. I'll handle Count Burgles myself, and I will vanquish him.
But, Holst, can you really afford to be away from our territory for so long? Elmira could strike at any moment.
This conversation certainly got heated. Do I sense another roundtable meeting in the works?
Seems like this kind of decision would be one of those conferences, huh? That's how it goes around here, yeah. I guess we'll just have to table this discussion until then.
I've returned, Father.
Yes.
Father, between your feigned betrayal and surprise attack at the Great Bridge, your leadership in this war has been nothing short of exceptional. However, I must ask why you felt it necessary to exclude me from your plans. I could have assisted you had I only known your intentions.
No. If Teodril had fallen, House Gloucester would have remained a loyal vassal to the Empire. There was no need for you to share the stigma of that betrayal. Wanted your hands to remain clean. You are, after all, the heir to the noble House Gloucester.
Father.
But I will tell you this. Claude von Regan is dangerous. In this matter, I allowed him to inveigle me into going along with his scheme. And what was born of this plan of his? Much of our domain became a battlefield. Its citizens exposed to considerable peril.
That seems a small price to pay considering all we have gained.
An Alliance leader who dismisses any amount of suffering is unfit to bear the title. I am convinced that Claude will never understand this.
Now, that is not necessarily...
Listen to me, Lawrence. I am done obeying that reckless child.
You cannot mean to secede from the Alliance.
No, of course not. I intend to yield my title.
Oh!
What?
God may be the one to save our Alliance, but I refuse to serve under him all the same. You, however, are much more adept at dealing with his particular style of leadership. Would you not agree?
You are proposing I become head of this house? Are you certain?
Lawrence, my son, I have long forced you to uphold my own ideals. That too ends today. Going forward, you shall act in accordance with your own beliefs. My only stipulation is that you never forget your duty to protect the common folk and always consider their best interests.
My word. I stand both honored and humbled to accept the countship of House Gloucester.
All right. Mm-mm.